you have joined us for something very special this morning on Studio 10. Psychic medium Lisa Williams is here to do some audience readings. Lisa, take it away.
Awesome, thank you. Okay, I have to come to the two ladies here, Pink and the one in the jacket, and dark jacket. Between the two of you, there is a lady that's standing with you, and I'm not sure if you're related, but I've got a mother figure. So has your mum crossed, please? Would your mother have passed over? She's still with us.
I don't know.
All right, okay. It's in this area. There's a lady that's standing here, and I keep being shown there's a feeling of cancer. All right, so somebody passed with cancer. Can you understand this? Or am I back there? It's just in this area. No? Right. Can you relate to this at the back? There's a lady that passed with cancer.
Cancer.
Has your mum crossed?
Yes.
Do you actually have her jewellery? Is there a connection with a ring and a necklace? Thank you. And there's a connection. I'm going to tell you there's a connection to cancer. Would your father have also crossed over as well, please? Thank you. Because I'm being shown. So she was standing right there, and I was like, I've got it. It's in that area. All right, let me go with this. You're named after somebody, or there's a connection to the name, either after your grandmother or there's a following of the name. Would you understand this?
Yes, I do.
Thank you very much. Now, would you understand the name John?
Yes.
Thank you. And would that be connected to your father as well?
No.
Okay, who's the name John?
In-law.
Okay, and this person's passed over as well?
No.
All right, he's still with us. They want to talk about John. I'm not sure whether John is not well, or there's a feeling of illness around John, because I'm being shown that they want to talk about John, almost like just to watch out, just to be careful. I've also got a problem with the chest area. Someone couldn't breathe towards the end. Was this my mum, please? Mm-hmm. All right, because yeah. She's giving me this laboured breathing, very difficult. Thank you. Yeah. She's also making me aware that you were right by the side of her. She needs to thank you for being right by the side of her as well. All right, and she's saying that she couldn't have done a lot without you, because you really helped her and you were the person that took care of her. Would you understand that? All right. She needs to thank you for all of this. She's also given me a happy birthday. So whether there is a birthday that's coming up, would you understand that, please? Okay. Yeah. And she wants to give a massive happy birthday. She's also talking about your hair. Have you recently just had it cut or done?
No.
Right, she loves how your hair's been done, all right? She really likes, she says it hasn't changed, but you look amazing, all right? Now, she's also acknowledging a sister. Now, I would believe that she had a sister in spirit as well. Is that correct?
No.
All right, or a sister-in-law, because there's some form of sister in spirit with her.
She was very close to my father's sisters.
Right, OK, because she's bringing me in with the fact the sister's in spirit with her as well. Mm-hmm. OK, show me what else. She's also given me difficulties with her legs as well, so she couldn't walk, and there was problems with the legs. Your father's a quiet man, but I do want to say he's quite a jovial man once you got to know him. I do feel as though he could be a bit of a practical joker if you wanted to be. Does that make sense to you?
Oh, I didn't see that side, but
right.
Probably.
he's got a practical joking way. I don't know whether that's the side, but he's quiet as well. Mm. All right. No, sorry. Can I just change that? It was your mum that was a practical joker.
No.
Who? Am I switching spirits? Who's the practical joker? Hold on one second. Let me just put him on hold. We've got a gate crasher. All right, happens. Gate crasher can sit there. Let me finish off your reading.
Okay.
Your father's quiet, all right? He's very quiet. Hi from Dad. All right, is what I'm going to say. Mum wants to tell you that she loves you, all right? Happy birthday. She's given me this feeling that she wants to thank you for everything that you've done for her. And she's saying you're keeping her memory alive. Are you wearing her ring by any chance?
Not today, no.
Right, but do you normally wear it?
From time to time.
All right, because she's saying weathering.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to love and leave you with that. Okay.
Okay.
Right, let's bring back the practical joker. All right. Let's have a look. Where are we going? I'm coming in this area. I could be completely wrong. My GPS, my psychic GPS could be off. But I'm coming in this area, and I do have a father who is showing me that he was quite a joker, quite mischievous, quite... like he would hide things, or he would be an absolute practical joker, and he's like a father or a grandfather. And I want to put it in this area. Can someone relate to this in this area? Where's the name George? Can anyone understand the name George? Can you understand the name George? Would this be your father?
Mm-hmm.
And could he be quite a bit of a joker and quite a chatty... And he's crossed over, correct?
Mm.
All right. Now, bless him. Bit of a sensitive guy. Would you understand this?
Yeah.
There's a real sensitive side to him. And not many people saw the practical, funny side to him. All right. But when with the children, he could be really funny and really get onto their level. Does that make sense with you?
Yeah.
All right. Now, he's coming here. Thank you. He's saying this is the last person you would have expected to come through. All right, because he is that quiet sense. All right. Come on, my love. He said it's not his energy to normally come forward, but he needed to come forward because for some reason his passing has really had an impact on you. And he's saying he never got a chance to say goodbye to you. All right. And this was very difficult for you to kind of process and come to terms with. Can you relate to this? All right. I know, obviously, it's emotional. And he's just said, I'm always with you. And you've been talking to him recently, or you've been communicating, wondering if he's still with you. Thank you. Would your mum have crossed over as well, please?
No.
Right. Well, he's been with your mum. He keeps saying, I'm with mum, I'm with mum. Although that was a turbulent relationship, it wasn't always an easy one. Would that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, come on then, darling. Okay. All right, very smart, all right? He's very smart in his appearance, but you take him as you find him, okay? Very comfortable man. He's also shown me he was quite quiet. So, again, him talking in this capacity is quite unusual for him. You understand this? Okay, he never got a chance to say goodbye. He wants you to know that he's okay, thank you. He's saying it didn't hurt. I need you to know it didn't hurt, however it passed, all right? What else, my love? He's also got an animal with him. Either there's dogs or cats, but he's got animals with him as well. He wants to acknowledge this. What else, darling? He said, just tell her I'm okay. And he now believes. So either he didn't believe in the life after death before, but he's saying, I have to believe now, because that is so important. Who with the boy, do you have the son?
Yeah.
Because he wants to acknowledge his son. All right. He needs to acknowledge your son. Your son's still with us, is that correct? Because he wants to acknowledge your son, and he's showing me that he doesn't always listen. He's a kid, all right? He doesn't always listen, but he's showing me that he's actually with him and just guiding him along, just nudging him in the right direction, okay? He also wants to say change his shoes, or he's got to change his shoes, so whether he's doing something with his shoes, but he's got to change his shoes, so I'm going to leave that, ask him. What else? And he's also keep being shown that... Does he drive as well, your son?
Mm-hmm.
He needs to be careful in the car, because sometimes he's a bit of a speed merchant. Does he like to put his foot down?
Mm.
Yeah, he's a kid. Mm. All right. Just tell him... he's not going to be in an accident, but they're just saying, hey, just tell him to be calm. All right. OK, he said, I'm going to go now. And he's such a sensitive guy as well. All right, OK. He's saying, I love you. All right, so I'm going to love and leave you with that, OK? OK, I have a lady that's coming through. She's just given me the name Betty. Well, don't anyone understand the name Betty? As either, like, an aunt or someone? Betty? That's OK. OK. Do you mind if I come to you? All right. And would this be Aunt Betty?
No.
All right, but Betty's in spirit?
Yes.
OK. Who would Betty be?
Grandmother.
A grandmother. All right. She's putting a princess... She's putting a tiara on your head, which makes me understand that either you were the favourite or you were the princess of the family, all right? But she's acknowledging you here, right? Now, she's also making me aware that... Would this be on your mother's side as well? Because
mm-hmm.
She's giving me a connection to your mum here. And she's also showing me that her husband, which is your grandfather's mm-hmm. also in spirit, but your mother is still with us. Am I right mm-hmm. in saying this? Because she's acknowledging your mum still being with
mm-hmm.
us. Thank you. She's also showing me that mum may have had some slight health concerns. You understand that?
Yes.
And she's saying that she's been with her and kind of journeying along this journey with her. It hasn't always been easy for her. And she's actually happy that you're there by the side of mum holding her hand. Okay? Although you and mum don't always see eye to eye,
mm-hmm.
all right? She knows that sometimes it could be a difficult relationship, but she's laughing because she's saying that her and her mum were exactly the same. You know, the dynamics are like family mm-hmm. carrying on. Okay. Oh, she's quite a lively one. You know, she's like chat, 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 very happy. She wants to say congratulations for you. So either there's been new journeys, new beginnings in your life, whether it's work or something, but she's saying congratulations. This is really important. Okay, she's talking about being on time, always being on time, always on time, okay, always on time. Thank you. Your father is really strong, you know, kind of want to stand, your grandfather's very strong, stand up, like the perfect gentleman. I was going to say English gentleman, mm-hmm. but, you know, the perfect gentleman. OK, darling. Thank you. You don't bake like she does. All
no.
right? No one could bake like no. she did. Because I'm telling you now, she was awesome at baking. Oh. All right? She's just got this yeah. real knack for it. And she never measured anything out, did she?
No.
It was all like, pim, 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 put it all in. And she didn't really care. But that's how she's coming. And she used to bake these cookies, either for Christmas, but this particular cookie that was quite crunchy and I feel like almost shortbread. Beautiful, all right? Now, she wasn't good at... She could cook, but she wasn't good at the meals, all right? And I just feel as though everything was a little bit bland or too salty, OK? Because she's laughing about this. And she's saying, and you're not like this. So do you feel as though you can cook?
I'm OK.
You're OK.
Not
well,
great.
You're better than she is what she's referring to
yeah,
as
she
well.
She really only cooked one thing.
Yeah, well, I just feel as though it was pretty bland.
Yeah.
Whatever
yeah.
she could cook was pretty bland.
Yeah.
OK, show me what else, my love. She's given me music, that she comes forward in music, thank you. She's also making me aware butterflies and rainbows. Do you ever see rainbows and butterflies?
See butterflies.
OK, these yeah. are a sign from her that she's coming through. Mm-hmm. All right, can you look for the rainbows, even if it's just the prism that's coming through mm-hmm. on the lights? But she wants you to know that the butterflies and the rainbows are very, very significant as well. You have a daughter, is that correct?
No.
All right, who's the woman that's just had the tattoo?
My niece.
OK, there you go.
yeah.
She's not happy about the tattoo.
No.
Just going to tell you right now, she's not happy about that tattoo.
No, none of us are.
OK, good. Well, neither she. OK. What else, my love? She said nothing. I just wanted to come through and say hi.
Oh.
All right, she's super proud of you. She wants to get, you know, really happy about the fact that you're progressing in your life. She's so proud. And she's saying, can you just tell your mum that she's going to be OK? All right, so mm-hmm. I'm going to leave you with that.
Thank you so much.
To tell you that Kelly's actually one of the producers and was just sitting in there to fill a seat and didn't realise that she was going to be on the telly and get a reading.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Mm. Because Kelly, would you be the kind of person who would necessarily believe in what Lisa was saying initially?
Yes. I tend to do think that there's something more than, you know, there's something when you pass over.
Mm.
But, you know, I didn't expect... You expect to hear some names, but Betty...
Mm.
I wouldn't have expected to hear Betty, because that's my grandmother.
And how did you... I mean, how did you feel when you heard, oh, Betty, that's my grandmother?
Well, I was waiting for somebody else to put up their hand.
Mm.
Was you?
Yeah, I know. Because, you know...
That always happens.
She was like the matriarch of the family.
Mm. Oh, right. So everything was true.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
Mm.
Yeah.
That's absolutely fantastic. And now we've got a deeper insight into you, Kelly, as well. We know you're a halfway decent cook. He's a bit of a princess. All right, Lisa, carry on. Who's next? I can't wait to see.
Well, I've got Aunt Mary, that I felt like I got a connection to Mary. I'm not sure if she's aunt, but can anyone understand Aunt Mary?
Oh, well,
but your mother, Mary. OK, let me get more information before I direct it yeah. directly to you. Come on then, Mary, my love. And your father was also in spirit as well, please.
Yes.
Thank you, because I'm being shown that Mum and Dad are coming through together. Would you understand the fact there's a connection to a brother in spirit as well? So either for one of them or for yourself? Your father had a brother, am I right
no.
in saying that? Or there's a brother-in-law, there's some connection to a brother. Military connection as well.
We've got a few military connections.
Okay, don't worry. I'm going to carry on with it and we'll determine whether it's for you. Your mum, she's quite a tough woman, if you don't mind me saying so. Would I be right in saying that?
Yes.
I really would not want to get on the wrong side of her.
Yes.
Okay, I feel like... okay. Wonderful, wonderful lady.
Yes.
But do not cross her.
Yeah.
All right? I feel like she would completely, like, swipe you if you got it wrong
mm-hmm.
or did something out of place.
Yeah.
And she, again, a little bit unlike Betty here... I feel she was a great cook, all right? But she
yes.
had to cook because
yeah.
she had no choice. I feel like there was quite a large family around her, all right? So she was always in the kitchen cooking
yeah.
and doing for the family. Family was very... I do believe I am with you. Family were very, very important. You're a lot like your mother, but you have a lot of your father's traits as well,
yeah.
okay? Because she's showing me that you're strong like your mum, but you've got that sweetness of your dad. All right, now she's saying that, not me. All right, so listen. Now, she wants to acknowledge the fact that you two were very close, all right? You were close, but there was a distance between you, yeah. Okay? Yeah. And she's showing me that you stepped up or you stepped into that close role as the feeling of when she was passing, all right? Now, she's giving me the fact she knew she was going to cross. Would that make sense to you?
Yes, absolutely.
Because what she's showing me is that she prepared everybody and she was telling everybody that she's going to pass. Oh, I'm fine, don't worry about me. Listen, all get on when I die.
Yeah, she actually hugged me. Really tightly when I left my sister's place where she was at mm-hmm. the time, and she hugged me really tight and I said, it's okay, I'll see you tomorrow. And she knew.
She
and
knew.
That was my signal yeah. that she knew she was going.
She knew.
Yeah.
She knew.
She wanted to go.
She wanted. She was ready. She's yeah. like, I didn't want to stay here any longer.
Yeah, that's right.
She was done.
Yeah.
And she's a very open woman as well. Very yes. open. She's yeah. given me problems around her stomach area, so I do feel as though there was difficulties here. Again, a laboured breathing. But the other thing is, I just feel as though she wanted to go.
Yeah.
It was almost like, I'm just going to go in my sleep.
Yep.
And I do believe that that's how she did go.
Yes.
All right, because yep. she's making me aware that she just went to sleep and never woke up.
Yep.
All right, she said it was the best way.
That's
she
right.
She advise yep. it for everybody. Please don't. But super, super charming, charming woman, all right? Everything had a place in her house, all right? You move everything, she'd want to... She knew where everything was. Every nook, every cranny, yep. every little trinket, you can guarantee she knew exactly where everything was.
Mm.
And she would know if someone had been in her house. I almost feel as though... For some reason, she showed me her carpet. Like, I want to see just footprints in the carpet, and I've no idea whether why I'm seeing this carpet and these footprints running.
Because it was awful carpet, and you stepped on and left footprints.
Right, and we left footprints, because I'm like, why am I seeing these footprints on this carpet? All right, so, well, she's acknowledging the carpet and the footprint. I'm like, really?
She picked it.
She said, I made the wrong decision there. And everybody constantly kept going on about it, the fact that she'd made the wrong decision, this was awful carpet. And she's saying that she's glad that you chose something else for your house. So either you've got hardwood or you've yep. just had new carpets, because she's, she's making me yep. aware that it's very different.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Now, she's laughing. She's a great woman. She's absolutely great. Would you live near the beach by any chance?
No, I want to.
All right, because she keeps saying that she wants to put you by the beach. She wants to put...
Oh,
Mum, can you send the money for
yes,
it. It'd be
please,
nice.
Please, please.
But she's that kind of character, you know. She wants to help you out any time in life, all right? Now, your father's in spirit, am
yes.
I right in saying yep. that? Because your dad... Oh, I did say that.
Yeah.
Because she's just said, your dad's here. Hello from your dad. But she's the one that takes over, all right? And she wants you to know that. Now, you've got a sister.
Yes.
Okay. Are you two not getting on all the time?
Oh, no, we get on. We just don't talk a lot.
Okay.
That's all.
She
works and I don't.
Well, there you go. Let's just say she wants more communication between you and your sister.
Yep.
All right? And
yep,
that's
understand.
What she's referring to.
Yep.
Happy birthday as well.
Yes.
Would you understand the happy
yes.
birthday, please?
In 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks. Okay, so happy birthday.
Yep.
And she's saying to do something nice for you, but just don't drink too much.
Because
you're a terrible drunk. All right, so...
I don't drink.
Exactly. She doesn't drink. Just don't drink, all right? Because she's saying you can't hold your drink, all right? So she's just laughing about it. But your mum is one of these people that would share your secrets with everybody, all right? And I feel like that's what she's doing now. All right, she said, I better shut up. I'm like, hush. But I just want to give you a lot of love. Wait a second. I just want to give you a lot of love from her, from your dad. There's also a dog in spirit. Would you understand that?
No.
Who had the... Oh, I'm going to get... The dog's gate crashed. You sure?
No, yeah, no.
I got a dog.
My Ollie. He gate crashed.
He gate crashed. I've got Ollie here.
Come here, you little monkey.
Adorable. I mean, adorable. And would come right by the side of your leg.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, stand by, wag the tail, the whole thing. Oh, my gosh. And groomed beautifully.
Of course.
Absolutely groomed beautifully. Isn't this what... So I want to leave you with your grandmother, with your mum, all right? Lots of love. And I'm going back to Ollie, all right?
Oh.
I can't move my leg. It's ever so weird.
That's right.
It's like he's trapped here.
Don't stay still, he might wee on it.
Oh, no! I thought he might cook his leg. I have a feeling he might cook his leg. Isn't that funny. Oh, I love it. So this goes to show that animals can come through too, but really groomed. And you used to groom him all the time. And it was something that you would sit and do as a relaxation for you.
Yeah.
And more, and you know, he was like...
Yep. That's him.
And the other thing is I do feel as though either you had to make a decision about his passing, and I need you to know that you did the right thing.
Oh.
I need you to know that you did the right thing, because this was something that you tried to prolong and you tried to put it off for a couple of weeks. Does this make sense?
Yep.
And I need you to know that he loves you and you did absolutely the right thing, because he couldn't do it anymore.
No, he couldn't.
Aww. He couldn't do it anymore. And you used to hand feed him.
Yep.
You'd get down and you'd hand feed him. All right. By the way, he's left my leg and he's coming over to you now. But, I can move my leg now. But he and he's just peed up the other end. he liked to leave his little mark, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, everywhere. Yeah. Right around the neighbourhood.
Oh, yeah, he's leaving his little mark. But adorable. I need you to know, absolutely adorable. All right.
He actually got a tumour. He was only 10 and he got a tumour
in his stomach.
No, in his head.
In his head, right.
And, yeah, he had to be put to sleep.
Yeah, I keep being shown that you tried to prolong it for either 2 weeks or 2 days, but you tried to prolong it for two.
Yeah.
All right.
I didn't want to, though.
And you did the right thing.
Oh, good.
All right. So I'm going to love and leave you with that.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Sorry. Alrighty. Okay. Don't know whether I should say this, but I'm going to go there. Anybody got a murder? Someone who was murdered? There's a connection to somebody who was either.
Oh, not you again.
Yeah, really?
Me again.
Yeah. Can I go there? I'm really sorry. Well, who was the murder? A young man? A man who was murdered?
I know three people who were
murdered. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. And was there also a suicide as well? There's also a suicide for someone else who's passed.
Oh. Yeah.
I know who you're thinking.
You understand?
Yeah. We have a friend who...
Okay, who passed the suicide. Mm. All right, do you mind if I address you both?
Mm-hmm. No.
Okay. And it was a gentleman, is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Real fun-loving guy.
All right. Yes.
A bit of a flamboyant kind of woo, real fantastic energy, to the point where he would walk in and brighten up the room.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Brighten up the room, give this, and for some reason I've just got this energy of drugs. So there was either some form of medication or drugs around him. Would you relate to this?
Yep.
Okay. I got to tell you, great guy. No one would have ever suspected this of him.
No.
This was come as a complete shock. Mm. And I feel as though this was a multitude of a lot of things that built up upon him. But he's also making me aware that he did have this element of depression around him. But again, not many people knew about it. And I do believe that he was well known in an industry, that people knew of him. And it might have been in the TV industry, but I feel behind the scenes more so, OK? Real fantastic. Have a drink for him. Have a drink for me, darling. You know, please have a drink for him, because he is that guy, all right? You've got to understand that very, very casual, he would be the guy that would kick back, feet up, relax. He'd also be the guy that would be life and soul of the party, OK? Show me what happened. He said, I need to tell you I'm sorry. I need to tell you I'm really sorry. And if you can share that. He's got Facebook friends or Facebook fans.
Oh, God.
And because he's acknowledging the Facebook energy, and that you would be able to put this on Facebook and say, hey, I'm OK. Just let everyone know I'm fine. Mm. He's also showing me that it wasn't a snap decision. This wasn't a snap decision. This was something that he'd been thinking about, planning and preparing for some time. Because I do see that he'd had this element of depression. And I keep being shown that the mother knew about it. Or there's a feeling that mum may have known. All right, now whether mum is in spirit or here, I don't know. But he's also shown me, he said, can you just let everybody know I'm okay? Mm. And he's having the right party over there, as you would expect, being the life and soul of the party, okay? He's also joking about you constantly get changed. You constantly get changed and continually get changed and changed and changed. You never can decide what you want to wear. Or is this you?
No.
Why is he showing me handing you clothes all the time?
I'm not sure.
My best friend passed away.
Okay.
So he passed away with an overdose, and we used to party a lot. And
we would share clothes.
Gotcha. I'm coming to you in a second, because this I've got to go here, but I am coming to you because it's like in that case your friend has brought this guy forward. All right. Can we step aside, please? Because they sometimes merge energies. All right. Let me just finish off here. I want you, he's so proud. He wants to hug you both because he's a hugger. He wants to give you absolute hugs. All right. Really, really important, and he loves you very much. Okay. Yeah, may I address you, please? All right. Now. You weren't expecting this, were you?
No, not at all.
All right, you have a tattoo for this gentleman?
Me?
Yeah.
No, I don't think he has.
Does he have the tattoo? Were you talking about getting the tattoo together?
No.
There's something about significant is that he's talking about the tattoo. Or is it connected to you two?
No,
I didn't think it was. It's to you. I can't make it change. I'm going to leave it with you. Do your homework, have a think. Something about handing you clothes. Changing clothes. And would you ever go to the beach?
When I moved back to Australia, he lived right beside the beach.
Okay, and you went together?
Yeah.
Right, because I feel like he did a practical joke on you at the beach. Either he hid your clothes or there was some practical joke, but I just keep being shown...
He would do pranks with me all the time.
Okay, good. I also keep being shown, like, I want to be the person that would drink a load of beer, have a fire and watch on the ocean. I just feel like I want to sit and drink with him, all right?
Yeah.
That kind of guy.
Yeah.
He's punching your shoulder almost as if it was kind of, you know, hey, how you doing? Yeah.
We would actually do that, punch each other.
Okay, good, because he's punching your shoulder. I can't get away from the significance about a tattoo. So either that someone has had a tattoo for him, but there's a significance about his tattoo. So if you can do some homework. Now, oh, interesting. He keeps talking about, have you ever had a phone call on your cell phone and no one's been there? Or you've ever had a message on your phone and you don't, like from an unknown number?
It would happen occasionally and I knew it was him.
It was him. I need to just confirm the fact that that was him because he keeps acknowledging this. He's also joking about a six-pack on his stomach. All right? I do think as though it's a joke. All right? But I feel as though there was always this joke, like, I've got a six-pack and maybe hold up some beers. But there's just a funny situation about the stomach, OK? Mm-hmm. His overdose was not intentional. Would you understand that?
He was under a lot of medication and he got carried away with medication.
Yeah, but it was not intentional.
No.
I need you to know that just because he got carried away with the medication, it was not intentional for him.
Okay.
All right? It was more a case of, I'm just kind of enjoying this buzz. I'm enjoying the high.
Yeah.
And I feel as though there was alcohol also involved with the medication as well. Mm-hmm. All right? He needs you to know that he's absolutely well. Who's the sister? Does he have the sister or you have
the
sister?
He's got two sisters, I think.
OK, he wants to acknowledge the sisters. Again, want to bring Facebook into it. You need to acknowledge it on Facebook. Where's the birthday? Would it be his birthday that's coming up?
No, it's at the end of the year.
OK. There's something about... whose birthday's in July? What's the July connection?
I'm not too much good friends with his family.
Okay.
But I know his mother, but...
That's okay. I'm going to leave it with you. There's some form of celebration or acknowledgement in July. All right. He's also wanting you to get your leg checked out. So either you've... Have you had problems with your leg or your knee?
Yeah, my leg.
All right.
Groin injury.
Can you get your leg checked out? All right, because I just feel as though it's... You might think it's, oh, I can cope with it, but again, just keep it checked, keep an eye on it.
Yeah.
All right? I want to call you bro. I'm looking after you, bro.
Yeah.
All right? That kind of dude thing. He said not in a million years would he ever think that he would do this, but he had the opportunity because your friend pulled him in and wanted to connect with you. All right? Because either you don't believe in it or he didn't believe in it, but he had to come forward and say that he believes.
Well, I don't believe much in this, so that's why I'm a bit more surprised than anything.
Well, that's what he said. Yeah. Now, what's the odd sock thing? Do you wear odd socks or have you got odd socks on today?
No, not really.
Did you ever wear odd socks? Is it? I don't know.
Nothing comes to my mind.
Okay,
right,
I'm going to leave it with you, I think. All right, so thank you so much for stepping forward. No, you're welcome. I love it. Oh, my God. All right. You all okay? Now you're all going, come on. All right, let's see. Joe or Joey? Can you understand? All right. Are you Joe?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. And your father's crossed?
Yeah.
Thank you, because I've got Joe that's... I've got your father that's stepping in. Would you understand the other name, Joe or Joey? So either he was named Joe or there was a... No, you have his name. There's a following on of the name. Do you have his... Is your second name his name? Or there's a connection to someone's name following on?
No.
Grandfather with him?
My mother's father was... had my name, yeah.
Okay. Well, that will work for me.
Okay.
Because I kept being shown there's another Joe in spirit, or there's another someone else in spirit. So your grandfather's in spirit, correct?
Yeah. Well, most of them are.
All right. Well. Okay. Well, we could be here for a while. He's coming forward as well. All right. But it's your father that's actually stepping forward here. Thank you. I'm being shown that you're a little bit of a chip off the old block. You're a little bit like your dad. Okay.
Probably.
Very much like your dad. He's also telling me how proud he is of you for being a gentleman. All right. So you must be, you know, an ultimate gentleman, which is great. But he's showing me that you've really stepped into that space, and he's showing me that he was very proud about being a gentleman. So he was very... I don't know whether put together is the right way, but I just feel as though he... There's just this strength of a man about him. Do you understand this? And he's very proud of the fact that that's what he was. I also don't feel as though he's like huge life and soul of the party. I feel like he's quite quiet. So for him to come forward, he's a bit, oh, hello, Dad. You're a bit quiet. Now, your mum is also in spirit, correct?
No, she's in palliative care.
Okay. She's shown me that he's been with her in that case. All right, he's been with her. Show me what else then, my love. He's just said he wants you to know that he's been with your mum, and he's also telling me that you've been very concerned about your mum, okay, which is only natural, all right? And he's just, listen, we all have to go at some point, okay? We all do. You can't escape death and taxes, let's just face it. Those are two things we can't get rid of. But he's showing me here that he is helping her, and in her transition, he will be there. And so I thank you. And he's just said, can you tell her? Whether she'll understand it, can you let her know? I feel as though he was the love of her life. The absolute love of her life. You understand that? And they may not have always got on.
No,
they may have, because I feel as though...
Oh, yeah. Mum's pretty fiery.
Oh, yeah. But she was the love of his life. And she was always beautiful. She was the queen. Was she the dancer at some point? She loved to dance.
Oh, she loved to dance and sing around the house.
Yeah, because those are his happy memories. Those are his happy memories of her dancing, of her just being charming. Do you also have a brother as well?
Yeah, Luke.
That's right. Because I just keep being shown it's the boys, all right? Your mum looked after the boys, okay? Very, very important to understand here. Let's have a look. And your brothers are still with us? Okay, because I don't feel anyone in spirit, you know, but I just wanted to double check. Okay, come on. Again, they're not coming through. He's not coming through as strong, but it's just like, I just want you to know that I'm with you, all right? Now, there's been some contracts that either you've been looking at signing or some form of new documentation that is coming through, either for you or your brothers. Is someone changing their job or changing the house?
Well, I've changed my job. Well, I've left it.
Okay. Are you looking for a new job?
Not in a hurry.
Okay. Well, he's telling me that there's going to be a new contract that you'll end up signing, all right?
Okay.
It won't be for a long period of time because you don't want anything for a long period of time, all right? You want little contracts, bink, 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 bink. And that's what he's making me aware of. It's coming, it's coming, it's coming. And he's showing me that anyone that takes you on, it will be a joy to work with. You're a joy to work with, but you're also hard. You know what you want, all right? You're firm. I don't want to be... you know, employed by you, because I'll be like, oh, okay. Not really. But it's like, you know, you get results, and your dad is really proud of the fact that you get results. Mm-hmm. And he's just saying, go for it. I'm proud of you, son. And again, either you've been sceptical about this or your father was sceptical about this, but again, he had to come forward just to say, hey, here I am. All right? Now, who's got the small tattoo that they had when they were a kid? It's not you. All right, I'm going to come back to it. So let me love and leave you with your dad.
Okay.
All right, great guy. And your mum's going to be okay. Your dad's going to be with her. I don't know when it's going to happen. I don't really want to look at it. But just know that she's doing okay.
Thank you.
All right, you're welcome. All right. Can you carry on? Yeah? All right. someone has a tattoo that was old, that's been old, like either you had it when you were a kid and you regret having it, but it's something small. Does anybody understand what I'm talking about? Like an old blue, like a, okay. It's a gentleman in spirit, let me put it this way. I feel like I want to go with old army, old navy tattoo, and someone had a lot of tattoos on them. Because they remind me of my Uncle Tom. Okay. I don't know why. Can anyone relate to Tom then? No? All right, well, I'm going to let them go if you can't relate to it. See ya. All right. No, I've still got it. There's someone younger in spirit that had a lot of tattoos on them. A lot of tattoos. I keep being shown either an arm of tattoos or something down here. But they're old tattoos. No? Because you know when the tattoos sort of spread and they get old and wrinkly, it's like that. Okay, we'll leave it. Maybe they're showing me I shouldn't have any more tattoos. Uh-huh. Right. Okay, let's come with this.
Lisa.
Oh, gosh. Ooh, it's come from the air.
This voice isn't in your head. We're going to send someone out. Someone in here thinks it might be them.
Okay.
We don't know, but she's coming out and we'll find out if it's her.
Awesome. Right. Thank you.
Kaz is on her way out.
That shocked the life out of me.
Can anybody relate to Rob?
So it turns out that all our Studio 10 producers are psychics. Yeah.
That's so weird. Hey!
My granddad was telling me
how
to tattoo
it. Yes, baby!
I didn't know him, so I don't
That's
know
okay. I don't care whether you knew him or not. At least you can relate to him. Yeah. All right, okay. Oh. Okay. So your grandfather was named Tom.
Yeah.
And he had an old tattoo that he hated.
Yeah, on his arm.
On your mother's side.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's you.
Oh, God, not again.
Listen, I can't change it. When it happens, it happens. Okay. He hated this tattoo. Do you have a tattoo as well?
No.
All right, good. Because he's showing me that you should not have tattoos good. For that reason.
Okay.
All right, and it's just something that he's acknowledging here. Now, your grandmother's also crossed over though, yeah. haven't you? And you knew her.
Yeah.
All right, now, the interesting thing was is that Tom needed to bring forward your grandmother. All right, and that's the reason why I couldn't let go of that connection. Now, he was a shorter man, wasn't he?
I don't actually know.
Okay, we're a shorter man with a bit of a waddle to
okay.
him. All right, that's how he's coming across. Your grandmother is a strong lady.
Yeah.
All right. Do not get on the wrong side of your grandmother, but very adorable.
Yeah.
All right. I really want to say, you were one of her favourites. All right. Yeah. You were very. And were you ever the dancer when you were yeah. younger? Because she's acknowledging you dancing, loving to prance around the house and just enjoying that side. And she's acknowledging the fact that you used to make up dance routines in her house.
Oh.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. And did you ever want to be the dancer?
I used to do it for a lot of years.
Okay. Because she's acknowledging that you were the dancer, okay?
Yeah.
And she has either had a lot of photographs or a lot of memories of you doing this. She was always there to support you. And I'm almost feeling like she either made... sewed the sequins on your thing or either sewed outfits together.
My mum did.
Okay. Well, she's acknowledging that this has been a memory for her, okay?
Yeah.
Now, your mum is still with us, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, she wants to acknowledge your mum. She loves your mum. She loves your mum dearly. You and your mum are close.
Yeah.
All right, very, very close. And your grandfather, sorry that he had to come forward, but it was really important that your grandmother came through. Now, did you ever call her Nan?
Yeah.
All right, because I wanted to say Nan. I almost said it was Nancy, but it was Nan, okay? Okay, come on then. She says, oh, don't cry. She hated anyone crying. Oh, don't cry. And again, I want to put you in the kitchen with her. I feel like I want to bake cakes, you know, the apple pies, all of those things.
Yeah.
You would always try and help her, but it would be a mess if you got in there, all right? Because she's... And you would always lick your fingers as you were... doing this stuff. She's like, stop it, stop it, stop it. But she's saying it was extra love.
Okay.
And she's laughing about the fact that, you know, you digging your fingers and licking it was all a bit of extra love, okay? Do you happen to have your grandmother's ring?
No.
Okay.
Oh, no, I don't. Oh, yeah, God, I do. I literally got it
like last the end of last year.
And your mum gave it to you. All right, because she's shown me that your mum should have given you the ring.
Yeah.
Don't forget about it just yet.
No. it's really similar to my engagement ring, so I don't wear it.
Yeah, because she's acknowledging the ring that was given to you.
Yeah.
She also keeps showing me that it was very special. Keep it. And you don't have any children yet, do you? All right. Do you want to know everything?
Yeah.
Okay, give it to your daughter when you have the daughter, okay?
Oh, wow.
Sorry, I just have to share it, okay? Because she's showing me, give it to your daughter, and that's important. Okay. She's so proud of you. She's proud of your career, where it's taken you, what you've done. She said you've made drastic changes, and she's super happy. Have you just moved?
No, I moved a while ago.
All right. Okay, there's something about a new energy in the home. Or new energy, so either you're redecorating or there's something about redecoration.
Okay.
She wants to show, and there's a cat. Do you have a cat?
No.
Connection to the cats. Like cats?
They had a cat.
All right, because there's cats in spirit with her.
Right, they had a cat, yeah.
I don't do cats.
It's smarty.
Yeah, I don't do cats. Anyway, there's a cat there, flicking its tail, you know. But your grandmother just wants to give you so much love. I mean, so much love. She's putting something around your neck with if you don't want to give this ring to your save it, she's showing me put it as a necklace or take the diamonds out and put it as a pendant of some form, and that's what she's acknowledging here. What else, my love? She said I just had to come forward and say hello. It was her opportunity. All right, there's some element of skepticism, whether you weren't sure, you were a little bit skeptic, but she's saying she had to come forward. She's also putting books in your hands, so either you're an avid reader or she used to read to you, but she keeps acknowledging the books as well. All right. So I'm going to love and leave you with that.
Bless you.
I'm so glad that we found you. Oh my God. Always happens. Always happens. Oh. All righty. Where's Rob? Who's Rob? Who's the connection to Rob?
Don't tell
me. Oh gosh. I just heard the name Rob.
It's our producer.
He's the one Rob. Who was speaking to you before.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Rob, is your grandfather in spirit?
Oh, God, now he's coming.
No.
I'm just going to tell you now, I've not met any of these people in my whole life. I really haven't.
He's coming. I think
Rob's
going to be coming out.
I can hear footsteps. Yeah, I can hear footsteps.
Here he is.
Hello.
You know what I would love?
What?
I would love you to do someone that's not part of this team.
I know, I'm sorry.
You know?
It happens.
It's probably not for me, but let's see.
Okay.
It can't be for me.
You've also got somebody else in spirit called Rob. Robert.
Well, my name's Robert. My mum's probably watching this thinking, Robert, you know. My grandfather was Rob.
Thank you.
Robert.
And I said to you about there, I went, you've got your grandfather here, come out.
Yeah. Sounds about right.
Yeah, here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
You don't think it's for you?
No.
Apparently you're a chip off the old block, all right? You're a lot like him, all right? This would be your grandma, your mum's, your father's side, because I've just been told, I won't say mum's and I got no father's. He keeps acknowledging fishing or I want to sit by the ocean. I want to sit by the ocean or fish or something like that, like a pastime of just sitting contemplating.
That might be him, not me.
All right, that's okay. Yeah, I didn't think it would be you. All right, but it was just him contemplating. He is talking about... you never got a chance to say goodbye to him. All right?
That's true.
You never got a chance to say goodbye to him. And I do feel as though either you were... I don't know whether it happened a while ago, because I do feel as though you were younger as well. And he's showing me that it was kind of a taboo thing in the family, like you didn't want to talk about death, or it was kind of not an easy subject to address, all right?
I just don't think it was really talked about.
Yeah, that's okay, because he's just showing me it wasn't talked about, it wasn't addressed. He wants everyone to know that he's doing okay, all right? And the way that he passed was easy in some capacity. Thank you. The reason why he wants to come forward, again, something about... An award. Have you won an award for the show, or is there an award coming?
Maybe the Logies this year.
There you go.
We can buy home.
Listen, when it happens, you'll go, that's psychic.
I promise you, if in the unlikely event that happens, I will give you a personal thank you.
Yeah. He keeps talking about you're heading towards an award. You're heading towards an award. And he's so proud of what you've achieved because this was a big step for you. Did you understand that?
Yeah, that's true.
It was a massive step for you and you were uncertain about doing it. Either you had two opportunities and you just... Because he showed me that there were two opportunities and you went for this. And he's saying, and you made it happen. You rocked it, you made it happen. And he's so proud of you. What do you always carry in your back pocket?
Wallet.
Right. There's something in your wallet that he's acknowledging. What's this in the wallet? I know there's a driver's license in there, but come on. Do you ever always have a certain thing in your wallet carries, like either it's a token or it's a piece of paper, but there's always something in there?
I don't plan to do that, but I think there's a Vanuatu coin. Right. In my wallet at the moment that one of my daughters put in there.
Because he just keeps acknowledging there's always something different in your wallet, OK? Now, the coins, do you often see coins on the floor, though?
Yeah.
These are from your grandfather. All right? He drops you these just as a sign that he's around you.
I thought it was just my forgetfulness, really.
No, not really. All right, so I want to acknowledge that. He's also showing me that he's just super proud of you. All right, that's all I can give to you, and then I'm going to read the audience. But
the thing I will say, the two different roles before I came here, that's absolutely spot on.
Yeah,
because not many people are aware of that.
Yeah, well, he's shown me that he was guiding you towards this one. So look for that award.
I will. Logie's 2016.
Honestly, all right, I really am going to try and stay here right now. I really am going to try. All right, can we have someone from the audience, please? Jeez. Is there anyone called Hillary or Hilda? Hillary, Hilda, Helen. There's a H-sounding name who's just come forward.
Helen.
Okay, and would this be your mum?
My mum's passed.
Your mum's passed?
Yeah.
And would your mum be named Helen?
No, Mary.
You're Hillary, sorry?
Her name was Mary.
And are you Helen?
I'm Helen.
Right, OK. Your mum has crossed over. You were close to your mum, am I right in saying that?
Yeah.
All right, because you were like this, like best friends. Yes, I've got someone in the audience.
Yay.
Awesome. All right, let's go with this, OK? All right, your mum's actually quite a fun lady, all right? Quite an outgoing lady as well. I feel as though she had a bit of a light, you know, she was really funny, she's very charming, quite sweet as well. But again, strong. Very strong. Do not cross this woman.
No.
I feel like you got Sharon Osbourne on your hands all over again, seriously, with this woman. No. Because she's such a... I mean, she's such a sweet woman, but very tough.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, and if you get in her bad books, forget it, OK? Forget it. She'd be really cross. And everything had a place in her home. Everything was just so. But you're a lot like this. OK? However, there's a part in your house that is a little bit, not messy, but you've got paperwork, it's either on your desk or it's something. She's saying, will you just clean that lot up?
Yes.
Just clean it up. There's dust, you haven't cleaned it, you haven't looked at it.
Oh,
and you've been meaning to do it.
Yeah.
You've been meaning to do it for a long time and she's saying, will you just get it done? All right. Now, your father's also in spirit, correct?
Yes.
Now, he's coming in with absolute shiny shoes. So I feel as though he would always shine his shoes. Am I right in saying that?
Yes, when he was a bit younger.
OK, you know, that's OK.
The end of
he's year. Shining his shoes. And what he's also making me aware is that your mum and dad used to dance together.
A little.
All right? Yeah. And he's got his dancing shoes on. Because your mum loved to dance and he was God.
Mum, yeah.
Oh. Yes, you know, because it was an effort for him.
Yep.
But he could really dance, all right? He used to take her around that dance floor and your mum was the most beautiful thing that he'd ever seen. He chased your mum. He chased your mum when they got together. She was not interested. Did you ever hear that story?
I know she wasn't interested.
Yeah, she was not interested. But somehow he got under her skin and she went, OK, under duress that she would go out.
Mm-hmm.
And it was that night that he charmed her. He pulled out the stops. And I've got to tell you, your dad was so proud of that, all right? You were daddy's little girl. Did you know that?
Sometimes.
Well, you were.
Yeah.
Your daddy's little girl.
I was only three brothers and I was only girl, so... Yeah.
Daddy's little girl, all right? Very much daddy's little girl. Very sweet energy. And he's showing me that you would always want to... you'd always want to kind of... make it known that, hey, Dad, I'm here, almost like you wanted to be part of him, all right? You always were there with him, okay? And I do feel as though you were close with your mum as you were growing up, but with him, is it was more a case of, Dad, just notice me, just look at me, all right? And he's shown me, how could I not notice you, all right? He always worked. He's shown me that he worked hard, and that is the reason why you were there, Dad, okay? Because he's shown me that he wasn't always in the house. And Mum is acknowledging this. Mum was the one that would take care, look after everybody, okay?
100%.
Now, has one of your brothers got some health concerns?
Yes.
Okay, they're coming forward to talk about your brother, all right? They're showing me that he's had some health concerns, he's had some tests that need to be done, and there's more tests that still need to run, all right? They are concerned about his health, but he doesn't listen. Your brother does not listen. Does that make sense?
Yes.
I just keep feeling like I need to give your brother a bit of a slap. Like, come on, dude, listen. Because he doesn't take care of himself, and he needs to from now on, okay? She's saying that they're doing everything that they can to help him. Could she not wear shoes?
Did she? I
feel as though her feet swelled or she couldn't...
Her feet swelled.
Because she's showing me, take them bloody shoes off.
Yes, yes.
Take them shoes...
And I'm bad.
Because I'm standing here and I feel like my feet are swelling.
Bad, yes.
You know? And I feel like she had a lot of water retention in her feet. A lot of 100%. Water retention throughout her body, actually.
100%.
Okay. Yep. She's also giving me her hands ached, her arthritis, or there was
arthritis bad. Yes.
Very much in her hands, okay? Because my hands ache here. And she's showing me salt for some reason. So I feel like I've got a lot of salt or sodium in my diet, which didn't help with this.
Yes.
And again, she didn't want to cut any of this out, all right? Because it was just, don't get to my age with all these problems for a reason, you know? But that's just her energy. She adores you. All right? She absolutely adores you. All right? She wants you to know that she's with you. Thank you for talking to her. Because you talk to her, don't you?
Well, I don't know if I talk to her, but I keep thinking of her all the time.
Well, that's her way of talking. All right? Even if it's just a thought process, you are connecting with her. And that's what she's so excited about. Thank you for keeping that. And also, keep singing. Do you
keep
sing?
Thinking. No, you don't want to hear me sing.
No,
she does want to hear me sing.
I'll tell you what it is. It's almost like you might want to sing something when the sun's shining, like, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine, and you make me happy when skies are grey. Don't know what I want to sing that.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Thanks. I just feel like I want to sing that with you.
Yeah.
So either you were her sunshine, but sing it.
Yeah,
all
okay.
Right? Even if you can't sing.
Yeah.
No one has to listen to you.
True.
All right, so I'm going to leave you with that.
Yeah, you were spot on, by the way, with everything you said.
Oh, good.
Well done.
Good. Yeah. Thank you.
Spot on.
Thank you.